This is Mason with DB Services, and today I'm going to be going over our demo file for the FileMaker Cloud Admin API. So with the release of FileMaker Cloud 1.16, they added a new API that allows you to manage your server all through a REST API. You can check the status of your files, close files, resume them, all sorts of cool stuff. But the most important one that you can do is you can manage your schedules on the API. So, which actually has not been possible up until this point. Server or cloud has never had schedules up until this point. And while you still can't actually manage your schedules yet from the actual interface over here, it's at least a good step in the right direction. And I'm sure in the next release there will be a GUI for doing this. But until then, you can use this demo file and manage them yourself now. You might actually want to use this in the future if you have multiple servers, because you can actually run and manage multiple servers, as you can see here. We've got a couple servers here. You can have as many as you want. The information you need to get this set up, you need to do a couple things. You need to type in the URL to your admin console here, your username and your password, and then you also need to make sure that your FileMaker Cloud is updated. From the dashboard, if you're not updated, it'll have an update button there. Once you're updated, you will also need to go to the notification up here, and from here there will be a message saying that to enable the REST API beta. You'll just have to join the beta, and then after that, that's all you really need to do, and then you can manage your schedules and everything from this file. So let's go ahead and just jump in and create a schedule. So I'm going to create a schedule for this FM Quick Start file. We'll just call this test. This is the username and password for the file. Do schedule test. And this list of scripts, this is just FileMaker programming. If you click this refresh button, it's actually going to open up the file and download that list of script names and then use that for the value list. So that's not really API specific, but just so you're aware how that's working. Alright, and then finally the frequency, so we can do daily. And if you're doing it daily, you can repeat the task every 1 minute. You could run every nth number of days. So if I wanted to run it every 3 days, run once, pretty self-explanatory, just run it once. Weekly, you can set it up if you only wanted to run on the weekdays. You could do that easy enough doing that. We'll say we want it to start today. We'll have it so it ends also today at 5 p.m. And let's go ahead and save that. All right, you can see that it's going to run at 10:55 for impatient. We can go ahead and hit run schedule now. So it ran at 10:54, and it'll still run at 10:55. Let's go actually make sure that it's running. So let me open that file. And what that script is doing is it's just creating contacts with the, just right there. But we don't really, we have a timestamp here, that's nice, but let's go ahead and actually add in a script parameter. And let's change this to run daily instead. All right, I'm just gonna go ahead and run it now. So we should have a new record right here. So yep, new record with hello world. That's working how we expect it to. So you can have as many schedules as you want to tells you which file they're related to, the name, the script, the status, if there's any errors. Hope you enjoy the file. Let us know if you like it. Thanks.